this is a mini science event that is a collaboration between ScienceU, the MRSEC, and Summer Academy here at Penn State each summer.
One of the priorities of the National Science Foundation is inspiring the next generation of scientists and making sure that the next generation includes members of every segment of the population.
This is a group, the blind and visually impaired, that is marginalized in terms of STEM education and opportunities for entry-level career pathway consideration. And so we thought it would be a great idea to offer an event where they could have a snapshot of at least one discipline. And this weekend, we're doing a forensic science mini camp, which is about 4 hours long. There's a case, and they're coming up here to solve it.
We were going to go through the crime scene cottage, through Spruce Cottage, which is part of the forensic science program here. We use it for crime scene investigation, and have the students find the evidence in there. Once they found the evidence, we had them go to our lab and analyze it, and we had blood evidence, so trying to see if the red stuff on the wall was actually blood. And we did what we call a leucomalachite green test for that. It's a color change, so they would get to use their adaptive technology for that. We found a question document, a torn note left behind by the suspect. We had soil evidence that they actually felt to see if they could find a tactile difference for it. And we had a scent clue, which was a piece of torn t-shirt. And they looked at that and then they smelled it.
See if it smells like. Oh yeah, that has a smell. It kind of smells the same as the other one.
It smells similar to me.
For these students, they had to, you know, get down on their hands and knees and feel around for something. Or they had to try to literally sniff out the clue with our scent clue. And they had to use their technology. So they had to think about it a little differently. They couldn't just walk in a room and go, oh, there it is, and go grab it.
Any group that is not currently served in the field of science is therefore needed in science. The students who are participants in the Summer Academy are exactly the kinds of students that we would like to see in the sciences.
So one of the things we hope the campers achieve today is to really just start to think about science and the opportunities they have to have access to science and science education at the college level.
The thing I hope most for these campers was that they realized that science is available for everybody. We asked them a question at the end, how many of them have taken a science class where they felt that maybe they haven't gotten to participate fully? And we asked them who thought they got to participate more fully in this camp and do more science in this camp than maybe they even do at school. And most of them raised their hand.
We are trying to promote accessibility in STEM career pathways. So we hope that they gain some insight on a hands-on, inquiry-based learning, and that they can do anything they want to when they get here to Penn State.
This type of collaboration should not be unique. This type of collaboration between scientists and educators and the public, all segments need to come together to communicate science and participate in the process.